In this video, how to install Hunyuan 2.1, quick and easy, optimization tips for low VRAM and comparison with top models. Hey guys, you asked it, you get it. So today we're gonna take a look on Hunyuan 2.1, a model that released around 2 weeks ago. This is just amazing. It's probably one of my favorite so far because there is one major advantage. It is open sourced and geometry and texture generation both works on low VRAM. 12 gigabyte is enough, and compared to most of the models, 12 gigs is low VRAM, and I mean this is amazing. So first step, let's go to official Git page of Hunyuan 2.1. then we need to find a ComfyUI wrapper. So I assume guys you already have ComfyUI installed. My guide is about ComfyUI portable. If not guys, there's plenty of guides. I don't want to send this video how to install ComfyUI. It is really easy. Also, you'll find the link to Notion comments where I will put all the links, all the commands. Feel free to use it. Alright, so when we are on the ComfyUI Hunyuan 2.1 wrapper, so then we need to go to our config. Then let's go to a Comfy folder. Then we go to ComfyUI and we need to find a custom node. Yes, this is another custom node. I have plenty of them installed already. You might have just few of them. But what we're gonna need to do is to press on pass and enter CMD. That will take us to command tool with this pass activated. So, and press enter. So we need to do copy Hunyuan 2.1. We can do it by git clone, and we need to copy paste our link. In seconds, you will have ComfyUI Hunyuan 3D 2.1 actually in your custom node folder. So that's it. If you do not have Git installed, the link in the same place. Let's move on. So as a next step, we need to download diffusion and encode model. This is also in Notion, so you can take a look where to download and how to name it and which folder to put it. It's basically the same as here. We basically go to Hugging Face, we go to Git and value folder and download the models. We will need to rename them and paste in the model folder. So this one will be renamed as this. So you basically can take this name and rename it. Diffusion model goes into ComfyUI models, diffusion models. You put it here with the name like this. And VAE model goes to VAE with a name like this. Boom, that's done. Okay, so the next step might be complicated as we need to install all the dependencies. And they might conflict and there might be many problems. So there's a custom rasterizer problem. For those who try to install Hunyuan 2.0, they might face the same issue. So I tried to create a step-by-step guide what commands in what order to use, so it's gonna work for you guys. So the first thing, we also need Hunyuan 3D wrapper installed. So we did it in my previous video when we installed Hunyuan 2.0, but the process is basically the same. So we can git clone this one in the same folder, and what we're gonna need to do is to run this command. Let's go into root folder of ComfyUI, type cmd. We're gonna need to build wheel for few tools that are used by geometry generation and texture generation. So one of the tool called custom rasterizer, it will compile slash build this tool to be accessible within your ComfyUI setup. Two things to make this happen, you'll need Microsoft Visual Studio build tools and CUDA installed. In many cases you might already have them installed, but if something goes wrong, there is a link in Notion in the very top for prerequisites. Make sure they are installed. It is simple as just download it and install it. Then try this process again. Okay, so the next we need to build one more tool. So let's do the same. Go to the root folder, press CMD and paste this command. So this command will install differentiable renderer for Hunyuan 2.1. Okay, let's run the wheel. As you can see, it's already installed on my side, lucky me. And right after, in the same window, we need to run next command, which will install the requirements for Hunyuan 2.1. Simply copy this command and run. Okay, so all the requirements satisfied. I'm cool, this one is done. Now at this stage, it's already my work on your side, but there are common pitfalls and common cases that something is still missing. So to avoid any problems, run two commands that I prepared for you. First, we will install a PyTorch Lightning. If this already installed, there will be no harm. And another one will need opencv-python. All right, so it's already installed, all good. Now, for you guys who did install in your config step Hunyuan 2.0, all, and some libraries might conflict. So if you do have it installed right now, you might need to double check one thing, the team dependency. I prepared two commands and you only need to run them if you used Hunyuan 2.0 before. If you did not, you can just run the second command that will actually install it. And it's done now. So let's open Comfy and check it out. And I already opened the test flow. To find these test flows, you can press workflow open, navigate to your Comfy folder, go to ComfyUI, go to custom notes, find Hunyuan 3D 2.1, and there will be workflow examples. So there's many workflows that you can play with. We'll take a look on mesh generation and full workflow. Okay, so the mesh generation is simply about creating a mesh without adding a texture. So we have an image here, we can rename the mesh, we can choose different format of it, we can save a file. There are extensive settings that we really don't need. What can be very useful is a target face number, which one you can control. So if you want a high poly model, you can increase this value to, for example, 15,000, and that will work fine. If you need something really low poly, you can reduce this number. One thing that you need to check when you first launch it is that the models that you downloaded are selected here. There's basically two places where you need to look, is VAE loader and mesh generate. So you press here and make sure the correct one, 2.1, selected right here and here. Because when you first type open it, there might be some values and naming might be a little bit different, which might cause it to not working. All right, so I already did a generation and you can take a look at the results. The next one, let's review a full workflow. This one is exactly the same as the example with one minor tweak from my side, and I will explain what I actually did. So we can take a look here. We have same control of polygons and on the name and same setting as in mesh generation. This generation took 100 seconds on my 12 gigabyte VRAM. And I think this is amazing. Like, you can create as many assets as you need without paying a penny. Also, when first time open the flow, don't forget to take a look on these two nodes to make sure that models are selected correctly. Otherwise, you will run it and they will be highlighted red saying like there is no such model, etc. So take a look on that. If you open a workflow first time and some nodes are highlighted red, it means some nodes might not be installed, like there's a KJ node or something like that. I have all of them installed as they are the same and they're mostly repeating from 2.0, but you always can go to manager, to custom node manager, press here on missing and select them and install. Just press install or pressing this button, install missing custom nodes. After that, restart it and it will work properly. This is Mr. Mark again, and he kindly asking you to subscribe and press the like button if you like this video. He read all the comments and come up with the new ideas for the next videos. We highly appreciate your support. Now guys, few tips. So the first tip is about VRAM. Even though this is optimized flow by itself, sometimes on my 12 gigs it was failing because of high VRAM consumption. And if that happens for you, you could tweak view size in this multi-view generator node. So what's actually gonna happen, it will reduce the memory consumption, it will lower the quality of view images, these images, and the texture might end up not that accurate, but you'll be able to run it. And texture size might be reduced, but 1K works fine. And another tip is to add background removal. So there are two nodes called in ComfyUI NV adapter. So you can install NV adapter through custom manager. Here it is. This is an amazing tool that we use with Hunyuan 2.0 to create textures. So you can install it, or if you have it installed, you just need to find two nodes. Double click, you find BRFNet NV adapter and image preprocessor. Now you connect them like this, it will basically remove the background. From my experience, this significantly improves the quality and remove plenty of artifacts. So in Hunyuan models, if you do not remove that shadow or something, it might actually create a 3D model. So as you can see, if I use background removal, I do not have anything, any artifacts on the bottom, etc, etc. So it is really useful. Okay guys, and in the end, let's compare Hunyuan 2.1 with top models. Okay, so I actually went to Rodin and Tripo and created some models. So let's take a look on how good they are. Okay, so what we can see is that Tripo actually do have some shading problem, but that's not a big deal. So as you can see, the quality is not too far from top models where you pay almost $1 per generation. For example, Rodin. A Tripo is cheaper, but if you ask me, in this case, Hunyuan 2.1 is actually better than paid one. I'm still surprised that Rodin Gen 1.5 still do artifacts like this. I don't know why. So like, why does it create double tail? I don't know. I never saw such artifacts from Hunyuan. A Tripa don't do that as well. So there is not much point to compare mesh because almost all models you can control mesh. So Tripa do automatic detection and suggesting like nice poly count, which is great. But you pretty much can control the poly counts for your models in nodes, right? You can set that limit and that will work. And same for Rodin. You can set the poly count limit and it will do fine. Okay, so the next test is Rodin. As we can see here, I can definitely tell something wrong with Tripa generation. And here is an artifact that I said this happens because they do not have automatic background removal, or maybe have, but it's not working properly. But this might happen to Hunyuan as well if you do not use background removal. Even if you create an image with transparent background in ChatGPT, it still has that hidden artifacts behind alpha layer that will do these artifacts. So note that. I can definitely say that Rodin did an amazing job here and it's very sharp and nice looking, but my Hunyuan 3D model is somewhere in between Tripo and Rodin, which I think is really great result. Yes, the texture quality here is low, but guys, I actually used view size 512, and if you have more memory you can add it like to 768, which is recommended, and you can increase texture size to 2k. This one is 2k texture and this one is 1k texture with 512 view generation. It's not perfect, but it's really good result and it follows prompt accurately. Okay, and the very last test. As you can see, the texture on Rodin looks really good and quite accurate. Tripo brings us some artifacts. You can see that it looks more sharper, but the thing is that it adds something on top, some texture artifacts inside. If you compare it with Hunyuan, that this one is more accurate, surprisingly. There are no artifacts here, not noticeable artifacts on the front side. There are definitely some things inside and I can see here. But again, guys, this is free model and this one is paid. But Rodin actually outstands in this example. But again, you pay almost $1 for this one. And there is a 2K texture here as well. In a conclusion, guys, I think Hunyuan 2.1 is really good model to work on concept, creating some props for games or video. Like, guys, you do not pay anything for that. And it works on low VRAM, which is amazing. Let me know what you think in the comments, guys, and see you in the next video.